Hinihingi mo yung sa GMA News Online, nahingin yung side mo. Sa dinami-dami mga vlog mo tungkol sa amin dito, may isang beses ba na humingi ka ng side namin?
Hindi, ako nagsabi noon. Kung ako nagtanong sa GMA News Online,
so, asik mo pa.
The journalists, ang mga journalists, pag mayroong isang balita na makakasama sa isang tao, dapat kukunin mo yung kabilang side.
That's right.
Pag hindi mo kinuha yung kabilang side, ang totoo niyan, hindi ko dapat, ano.
That's right.
Ito yung sinasabi ninyo, di ba naman yan, vlog yan eh.
No, I agree. Asik mo ka, sabi mo kay Mr. I'm sorry, what is your name?
Tordesilla,
hiningi mo ba yung side ko? And sabi niya, you tried. At sabi mo, hindi.
Hindi ko po, Senator, hindi ko po siya tinanong kung hininga niya yung side ko. Ang sinabi po, si Senator Soto po ang nagtanong. And also po,
sa tingin mo ba, dapat hiningi niya yung side mo?
Natural po. Journalist po sila, trabaho po nila yon. Kunin both sides.
In your case, never ka humingi ng side ng lahat ng mga nilagyan mong blog dito. In fact, just the other day, may blog ka sa minority. May isang beses ka bang humingi ng side namin?
Senator, with all due respect, hindi
yes
po
no?
ako journalist.
Yes or no? May isang beses ba na humingi ka ng side namin?
Vlogger po ako, hindi po ako journalist.
Mr. Chairman, Madam Chairman, can you instruct the resource person to answer yes or no, please? So, may isang beses ba na hiningi mo yung side namin sa mga times na binatikos mo kami, may nilabas ka mga peking balita?
Ano po yung peking balita na yun, Senator Bam Aquino?
Maglalabas po kami mamaya, no? But okay. Can I ask lang, Asik Mocha? Humingi ka ba ng side namin ni isang beses all those times na you blogged about us?
Ang ginagawa
yes
ko
or no,
po,
ma'am?
Senator Bam Aquino, ang ginagawa ko po ay blogging po.
Okay. Yes,
at hindi
I know.
Po ako journalist
ang
po.
I think, is yes or no?
Maybe the answer is no, but then your reason is because...
Wait, I'm sorry, Chairman. I want to hear it from Asik Mocha herself.
Okay, go ahead.
Yes or no? May isang beses ba na hiningi mo yung side
you
namin?
You can say yes, no, or that you refuse to answer, but you have to justify why.
I refuse to answer that
because,
question.
On the grounds of?
I have the right to refuse that question.
You don't have the right to refuse. You have the right to self-incrimination. So, ibig sabihin
nun, right
kung mapipermisyo ka, pwede kang hindi sumagot.
I have the right, ano po? I have the right to, ano, against self-incrimination.
Pasensya na. Anong krimen ang tinutukoy mo, Asik Mocha? Self-incrimination presupposes may krimen na pinapataw sa'yo. Ano
Senator
yung krimen
Bam,
na yun?
I refuse to answer that question. At lumalayo po tayo doon sa usapin ng fake news po ng GMA 7 po.
Senator
Bam, I think it's been made clear.
Madam Chair, I don't think we should embarrass our resource persons here, whoever they are, whether they're from the other side of the political government.
No, okay, Mr. Chairman.
Senator Miggs, I think, let me finish my point, Mr. Chairman.
But
Senator Miggs.
Yes. Before each and every senator should address the chair, rather than, including her, Secretary Asik Mocha should address the chair, so that we have order here, so that we don't embarrass each other. This is not.
I agree. Okay. So Senator
Mr. Chairman, if I may finish.
Address me, and then I will ask
the,
her.
The resolution filed by our colleagues, which is their right to file, talks about grievances, Mr. Chairman, Madam Chairman, Chairperson. It's okay. Pero palagay ko, hindi pwedeng pag-usapan ang grievance lang ng ilan. Because in our manifestation, we talked about fake news in general. We talked about wanting to push a law. Senator Villanueva has been good enough to file a bill on fake news. So palagay ko, Madam Chairperson, lahat ng ito ay pwedeng pag-usapan sa hearing na to. Hindi lang naman yung iisang resolusyon. Now, my question is, and it's a very simple question, sa mga panahon na nag-blog si Asik Mocha, tungkol sa minority, tungkol sa oposisyon, tungkol sa aming lahat dito, it's a very simple question, yes or no lang po, hiningan ba niya kami ng side? In the same way na yun yung hinihingi niya mula sa GMA News Online. So fairness ang hinihingi mo, Asik Mocha. You're asking that these agencies be fair to you. So ang sinasabi ko lang, hinihingi mo yung fairness, pwede bang bigyan mo rin kami ng fairness? So ang tanong ko po, Madam Chairperson, which you may ask her, and which I insist that she answers, humingi ba siya ng side ng mga oposisyon? Humingi ba siya ng side ng minority?
Asik Mocha, ganito lang, konting ano lang, payo ukol dito, hindi naman incriminating yan kahit sagutin mo kasi it doesn't imply a crime.
Yes.
It might be, others can probably say that it's incompetence or negligence or opinionated blogging,
okay,
but You can answer it.
Madam Chair, I would like to apologize for my reaction kanina. Dapat po pala kayo lagi ang in-address. First time ko po kasing maka-attend ng Senate hearing. At medyo malungkot po ako dahil wala po dito si Senator Trillanes. Una-una po, sir, karapatan po ng vlogger yon sa kanyang opinion, Madam Chair, kung gusto po niyang hingin niyang side ng isang tao. Opinion-based po ang vlogging. Unlike po sa mainstream media, meron po silang obligasyon po bago nila i-report po yung fake news na ginawa
po
nila.
So, Yusek Eggo, do you employ the services of ASEC Mocha as a blogger for PCOO?
Yeah, that's right. Thank you, Madam Chair. Number one, I'm not her employer, and like her, I like all of us here, we serve at the pleasure of the president.
Okay, so but who defines your official duties and functions?
Her official duties and functions?
Yes, all of you. Sabi mo, you're not her employer, but you must know, or she must be answerable to you. You're the USEC. So, blogger ba siya? Kasi kung ganon...
All right. She's assistant secretary for social media, and okay, ma'am. To answer you, I was a journalist for more than two decades. All right, so I'm now with government, and that's where the problem lies. No po, that's what I was talking about earlier today. That yung blogging. Especially now na nandito kami sa government, problema namin dito, have we lost our right under Article 3, Section 4 of the Constitution, the right to speak, to express our opinion?
Yes, you have. If you speak officially on a government side, you have. Unless you clarify that it's your personal opinion, but you should not use the government portal.
Yes.
Now, I just want to make it clear. So, GMA, hindi niya daw nabigyan si Ms. Mocha ng tanong ng pagkakataon na sumagot, no? Pero ito rin, yung sinabi ni Mr. Nieto dito, kaya nga natin, di ba?
Yes, ma'am.
Kaya nga ito, legislation, yung right of reply. Mukhang ngayon, baka nakikita natin yung pangangailangan nito para pag may nasiraan o may gustong sumagot, dapat bigyan ng pagkakataon. So, ganito na lang. Kasi ayoko nag-iimbento ka ng sagot dahil mukhang hindi mo alam yung clear definition ng mga trabaho ninyo. Bago pa lang kayo. I'd say bago, 1.5 years. Submit ninyo sa akin yung job description ng bawat isa sa inyo. Sabihin kay Secretary Martin. Para alam, kasi that's my committee, public info. And you're a government agency. Your liabilities are different than a common blogger or a private individual. So now, Robbie...
Madam Chair,
ABS. Sino nagsalita?
Madam okay. Chair, before. Madam Chair, just very briefly, dahil nabanggit nyo rin si Sec Andanar, and to the point we are discussing now, noong August 12 po sa Philippine Star, sinabi ni Sec Andanar, bloggers have to follow journalists' code of ethics. So straight from the horse's mouth, Madam Chair, salamat po.
Oh, sige. So isubmit ninyo uli yan with your signatures as...
One
employees
minute,
of the PCO. Yes, ASEC Banaag.
1 minute, Chairperson. Yes, ma'am. That is the opinion of Secretary Andanar, but it is not yet a policy. And of course, it is not a policy of PCOO, ma'am. That is his opinion, yes. Yes.
But isn't he the secretary, the overall secretary for PCOO?
Yes, ma'am.
So
yes.
When he uttered it, that is his opinion, but he has not directed it to be a policy yet.
In writing, not yet in writing, ma'am. And it
but
is
don't
not
you
yet
agree that that's actually quite
it
important?
It is very important, ma'am. We do
so
agree.
So you personally, you agree that you should have that, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So let's make it a policy soon.
Yes, ma'am.
So
and
that
we will.
This guy, Kohoy Dayao, should get our side first before he say we refuse to sign. Di ba?
And of course, ma'am, if I may comment on ASEC Mocha's status in our office, as reiterated a while ago, ASEC Mocha's blog is personal to her. When Senator Trillanes filed a case against ASEC Mocha, it was not the PCOO, and she will always be liable to whatever contents her post would have.
So you're saying that she can be held accountable for her personal views.
Yes, ma'am.
So now you have to probably make a clear
disclaimer
kasi
yes,
nga you carry the term ASEC. Eh. So,
yes, ma'am.
Pero yun ba yun? Nasa PCOO blog? Nasa PCOO
no,
site
ma'am.
Ba
yun? No, ma'am. It is not in the PCOO blog.
But did you carry it?
Yes, ma'am. It's a personal. No, ma'am. It's a personal blog by ASEC Mocha.
But were you linked not,
no,
in
ma'am.
That?
No,
no,
ma'am.
Okay, I just want to clarify.
Madam Chair, siguro for clarification na lang, since we're all government officials, we are bound by RA 6713, and under Section 4, nakasulat doon na we cannot use the excuse of doing things in her capacity as a private individual. So parang malinaw na at this point in time, ASEC Uson, hindi mo na pwedeng ihiwalay yung pagiging blogger mo sa pagiging ASEC mo. So I guess, di ba, para malinaw na talaga, baka it's high time for you to decide kung gusto mo maging blogger o kung gusto mo maging ASEC. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Okay, let us proceed now with... Do you
Thank
want
you.
To respond?
Yes, Madam Chair. Yung pagbablogging ko po, I think I am just exercising my right to freedom of expression, freedom of speech, at lahat naman po tayo ay may kalayaang ipahayag ang ating mga sarili. And also, gusto ko lang pong linawin na si Attorney Trixie Cruz Angeles ay hindi po, she doesn't handle my social media accounts. Kasi po ito yung kumakalat ngayon sa Twitter. So wala pong kinalaman si Attorney Trixie Cruz Angeles sa mga social sa aking social media account. Thank you, Madam Chair.
Siguro din, dahil napaka-epektibo ni ASEC Mocha, alam ko, umpisa pa lang, noon naman, you're very transparent, you've been a supporter of the President, perhaps she will also be more effective as, I don't know, like a PDB Laban na... blogger or somebody like, because it's political eh. I mean, whether we admit it or not, it will be viewed as something political, or unless you just report straight policy without comments. Okay, so this is a thin line that we really need to tread carefully and be very cautious.